Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to discuss with you the topic of cost of capital remaining part. In my previous video all about basics of cost of capital and cost of debentures and cost of preference shares. Today I am going to discuss with you that is the cost of equity capital. So let's start with the cost of equity capital. So here cost of equity capital. Before that we should know about equity shares. What does mean by equity shares? Equity shares are the shares which not have a fixed rate of dividend, and the shareholders of equity are the real owners of the company, is treated as a real owner of the company. Then come to the point, what does mean by cost of equity capital? Cost of equity capital is nothing but equity shareholders' expectations from the company. It is known as a cost of equity capital. It can be calculated in four different approaches. First one, dividend price approach, earning price approach, growth approach, realized yield approach. These are the four approaches of equity cost of capital. So first one, dividend price approach. It is all about the dividend. So dividend on the market shares, or shareholders expect dividend on the market price of shares. In formula it is simple, cost of equity equal to dividend per share divided by market price per share. It is going to be calculated or evaluated on per share. So here one example for that is a problem number one. A company issued 1000 equity shares of rupees 100 each at 10% premium and paying 20% of dividend. Compute the cost of equity. So here formula is that cost of equity equal to dividend per share divided by market price per share. According to that, dividend per share, how much here? 20% dividend is there. 100 is a share value and 20% is a dividend. Then how much? It is a 20 rupees. Then market price per share is a 100 is a face value at a 10% premium is there. So that's why 100 plus 10% premium means 10. So total how much? 110. So 20 divided by 110 into 100. We have to convert the dividend or cost of equity in percentage. That's why 100. So 18.80. It is a simplified answer, or cost of equity in case of dividend price approach. So next one, that is earning price approach. In earning price approach, all about earnings per share is determined on the basis of market price per share. So when the earnings are equal to present normal earnings, that time we have to use earning price approach. Formula for that is cost of equity equal to earnings per share divided by market price per share. Here one example is there. On that basis we have to calculate the cost of equity on earnings approach. Earning per share is 10 and current market price is rupees 100. Compute the cost of equity capital. So formula is cost of equity divided equal to earnings per share divided by market price per share. Here earnings per share how much? 10. Then market price per share, current market price is how much? 100 into 100. We have to convert, simplify it, that is a 10%. So it is a cost of equity in case of earnings price approach. Then next one, that is a growth approach. Third case is in case of cost of Equity capital is a growth approach. It explains dividend plus rate of dividend growth. Dividend is going to be growth. It means how much dividend is increased in upcoming years. It can going to be explains in growth approach. That formula is KE equal to D divided by MP, that is a market price, plus G. G means what here? D means dividend on current price or per share. Dividend per share on current price. Current dividend. It means dividend is a current dividend per share. Then P, market price per share, or MP, market price per share. Here P is there, it is a MP. MP, market price per share. Then G. G means what? Annual growth rate of earnings of a dividend. It means growth of a dividend. That is a nothing but G. So in simple terms, that is a K equal to D, dividend divided by MP, market price, plus G means growth. I will explain with one example, that is a market price of a company present is 160 and dividend is a 10 per share, and if the dividends are expected to increase at the rate of 9%, compute the cost of equity capital. Here dividend is going to be expect in case of increase at the rate of 9%. So that's why it is related to growth approach. So growth of dividend we have to calculate here, or it means simple term, that is according to growth approach we have to calculate cost of equity capital. So formula for that is K equal to D divided by MP, that is market price, plus G means growth of dividend in upcoming years. So D, that is the dividend, how much he is going to pay, that is a 10 per share. So that is a 10. MP, market price, how much? 160 is there. 160 market price. Plus G means what? Growth of a dividend. So here there is a 9%. Here clearly they have given, if the dividends are expected to increase at the rate of 9%. So see, converted, simplified it in per points, that is a 9% means 0.09. So compute the cost of equity capital. So according to this formula we have to substitute the values and simplify it and convert into percentage, that is a 15.25 is a answer. According to the growth approach, it is a cost of equity capital. Then another one approach, that is a fourth one, realized yield approach. It is also one of the approach which is under equity, cost of equity capital. It is used when the future dividend and sales price are uncertain. When the given problem or future dividend and sales price is uncertain, that time these approach is going to be used. And the realized yield is a discounted at a present value factor and compared with the value of investment. It is all about realized yield approach, and formula for that, that is a YT. YT means what here? YT equal to DT plus PT divided by PT minus 1. Here YT means yield for the year T, and DT means dividend per share at the end of the year T. Then PT means here price per share at the end of the year T. Then PT here, PT minus 1, price per share at the beginning minus 1. Here this is all about cost of equity capital. Realized yield approach is rare to use because in your syllabus all three approaches are very essential to know. Realized yield approach, it is just for your information sake. It is going to be used when the dividend and sale price are uncertain. So it is all about the equity cost of capital or cost of equity capital. If there is any doubt, you can comment and may take a screenshot and do study. Thank you for watching.